What's going on, guys? Player Junior back with another F1 2020 video. Today, you see we have a sponsor renewal or get a new sponsor. So let's go to manage my sponsors here. We've been with that sponsor for quite a while, but now we need to know and we need to sort out which ones will be getting us the best money, should we say, because we don't want any of these low-end ones when we could be going for a top-rated one, which will help us then get, you know, a better driver in it, get a better driver within the team. So achieve at least one podium position within the team. What else we got here? As a team, complete a total of 100 laps. We won't be doing that because we don't have enough laps. Achieve and hold first position for 4 laps. Well, we're always first position, so we could do that. But I think we might do the achieve at least one podium position within the team. So we could definitely do that. So let's go with that one. And we have a brand new sponsor, so let's go to the car and let's quickly do the customization for the team here, as we do have a brand new sponsor. Obviously, we want to get the sponsor on board, but where can we put it? So we've got Compass, Shark, Exxon, Shark, Compass. We have our new one, which is this one here, but there's no room for it, so we'll just leave it how the car is. Let's get back to the overall. We have a few activities fill up leading into the Grand Prix weekend. So let's have a look here. We have race simulator, weight training, driver promotion, sponsored event, filming, funded team event. So we're going to do the funded team event for 4 days, and then we'll do the power team building there, and then we'll also do the race simulator to get our drivers' awareness up. But yes, guys, this is another F1 2020 video. I hope you guys are enjoying this series, because I am. And I genuinely cannot wait to get into this race that is going to be the Singapore Grand Prix. And like I always say when doing these videos, if you're brand new around here, please do smash that like button. If you do enjoy the video, please hit the like button. And let's get into the race weekend at the Singaporean Grand Prix. What's going on, guys, and welcome to my qualifying pace here at Singapore. Right, there's a lot to talk about in this qualifying pace. Let's just say this track hasn't done me too well. I've completely done poo on this track. I don't know honestly why, but yeah, this track is not for me. And if you've come to see a P1 at Singapore today, then you are going to be very disappointed, as this track is not for me. I actually dislike this track a lot. It seems like all the street circuits I absolutely hate, or I think is poo, because they are very poo. But we have got our qualifying pace here, and we are currently not setting the fastest of time in the qualifying pace, and not setting the time that we need to be setting to take anyone by this race. But yeah, I genuinely don't like this track. I just hate it. I don't know why, I just hate it so much, and I cannot wait for this weekend to be over, because it has been up there with one of my worst weekends. And that's saying a lot. That's worse than Spain. Spain was worse, to be honest, but this has got to be near Spain. I don't know why, but this track hasn't just gelled with me. Doesn't work very well for the car. The car just hasn't done well on the track. And I know sometimes that, it's the driver's fault, not the car's fault, but on this track I just don't feel great with the car. Obviously at the moment I'm doing pretty well, but we haven't got into the difficult corners yet, and there's a few corners that just catch me out and I just stand no chance. So if you guys are here to see a P1 at Singapore, then my goodness, you are in for a shock, because I am no good on this track. As we do see Kimi Räikkönen ahead of us, as my Finnish friend Mr. Robert Keeley, who's been in the previous videos, told me that is how you say Kimi Räikkönen. It's not Kimi Räikkönen, it's Kimi Räikkönen, or something like that. But yes, as obviously Robert is Finnish himself, and so is Räikkönen. So yeah, we're doing pretty good for the qualifying pace at the moment. But honestly, it's been absolute toilet in all the other practices. So if you think, oh, it looks pretty solid around this track, no, this was just fluke. And yeah, as you can see, we did complete the qualifying pace and set one of the fastest laps of the race, which is 1:45. So they reckon that that result would get me in third. So obviously the car is not great around this track, but let's return to the garage. And yeah, that is it for the qualifying pace. Let's get into the actual qualification day itself, and I hope you guys enjoy. See you at the qualifying.
So far, our first lap is a 1 minute
Race, but before we begin, let's have a quick look at those who will be fronting the grid. Bird, Bottas, and Lewis Hamilton. With qualifying complete, all that remains is the main event. We'll be live and uninterrupted for the Grand Prix tomorrow, so make sure you join us. Backdrop of the Singapore skyline, Formula One returns once again to do battle in what tends to become something of an endurance race, with the notorious sauna-like temperatures in the cockpit making for an extremely physically challenging Grand Prix. The Marina Bay Street Circuit then has 23 corners, 13 to the left and 10 to the right, taking us a total of 3.1 miles around the landmarks of downtown Singapore. An average lap speed around here, just 107 miles per hour. And with me, as usual, is Anthony Davidson. Let's talk about Bird. Everything's on the line here today, and the title hangs in the balance. So how do you think they'll be coping with all that pressure?
Well, I try not to think about the result too much. The worst thing you can do in this situation is think about all the what-ifs. What if I get hit going into turn one? What if I get a penalty? What if I finish outside the points? If you let any of those kind of worries get to you, you can't focus on the job. So staying in the right mindset will be critical today.
Let's run you through the driver grid order for today's exciting race. Bird lines up on pole position, and it's Valtteri Bottas that completes the front row. Looking at the rest of today's grid, we have Hamilton, Verstappen, Sebastian Vettel, and Ricciardo, Leclerc, Sainz, Norris, and Alexander Albon, Ocon, Perez, Daniel Kvyat, and Gasly, Stroll, Raikkonen, Kevin Magnussen, and Antonio Giovinazzi, Aitken, Grosjean, Russell and Nicholas Latifi. That's it then, it's time to go racing as we head to trackside for today's race.
Wants another podium finish this weekend. I know you're more than capable.
So guys, getting into the actual Singaporean race here. Like I said, leading into this, I was very nervous. It is a 15 lap thriller of the Singaporean streets, and yes guys, and we are away. Looking behind us as Valtteri is going to come in and cut in to follow the racing line around, with Valtteri behind us. Obviously it was between me and him in the qualifying, bringing back that old rivalry that did happen midway through the season. Me and Valtteri actually did have a rivalry going on, but that seemed to have died off, and now I do have the rivalry with LW himself, Lewis Hamilton. LW, what the hell? LH himself, which is Lewis Hamilton. Christ almighty, it's been a long day, you can tell already. But yeah, as we do come round now to the tight corners here of the Singaporean streets. Like I said, leading into this, I'm not 100% confident on this track. And yeah, obviously it is a very tight track, and there is really, like, you have to be careful. There's a lot of corners that sort of catch you out because they are tight, etc, etc, as we do come through now over the bridge. This is the corner here. It's ever so tight. I'm slamming down on that brake, completely stopping the car to even get around that corner. That is an absolute joke how much brake power I need to put down just to stop the car. Look, I'm hard braking, man, through that corner. It's just absolutely insane. I'm literally slamming my thumb down to hold the car still. Literally, the car won't stop going forward. It's unbelievable. I know the car has a lot of power, but my goodness, it takes a lot to brake around these corners. Something I maybe should have looked at when doing my my qualifying is maybe look at the car's style. But my blimmin' goodness, it has been hard this track to try and just, you know, get around having to hard brake. Now we got Valtteri really pushing for it now on this right side as we do brake coming into the first corner. Now putting down the power as we follow it through, now into brake even more to get around that tight bend. You did see Valtteri trying to make a move down my right hand side, but didn't pay off as we do brake now, coming all the way through once more. And yeah, this race is not even started yet. It is getting hot now. Valtteri's going to be putting the pressure on us and this whole race now, as we do brake early on, as we are following it all the way through, like I've said before. And yeah, braking again, making sure that we don't screw any of these brakes up, because one mistake will then open the back passage for Valtteri to storm on through, which we cannot let him do, or we cannot let happen, because that will be an absolute nightmare. And hard braking there, following it through, putting down a little bit of power, but making sure that we are not putting down too much power so we can take these corners perfectly. As we do come over the bridge here, now braking hard, braking even harder, getting the turn, putting the power down through the corner. Valtteri almost slamming into the back of our car, and this is it. The speed traps down the side. We've got to brake even more than we've probably ever broken before. And yeah, we did those corners a lot better than we did it on the last lap. The last lap we seem to just not be able to, but as I do say that, the car's turning there into that corner is so tough. It is absolutely unbelievable as we do come underneath the bridge here, braking even more, following it through, and yeah, making sure we're braking all the while as we're going around this track. of the Singaporean streets. It has been absolutely phenomenal so far this race, with Valtteri really bringing the race to us. As you can see him going for the right side push, I have majorly blocked him there. As you can see, he has just tried to switch back on me, but luckily we did some great defending there, making sure that Valtteri could not get any closer to us than he already did. But he did try the old switchback maneuver on us. As we don't pay attention, we have to brake really hard there. And yeah, this race is only just going to get better and better as it goes on. But Valtteri is trying everything to squeeze past us. He seems to not be able to catch up with us when we're going around the track, but as soon as we get to that first straight, he is absolutely trying absolutely everything to blitz us and make sure that we do make that vital mistake. But we are holding on absolutely fabulously here, and yeah, I genuinely cannot think of how great this car is doing right now. But we have to concentrate, put the full concentration into the race, because if we do not, then we are in trouble. As you did see, the white line did just come up there of Mr. Valtteri Bottas chewing away on our hill there. And yeah, we're just doing phenomenally here, trying to just making sure that we are keeping up to pace with everyone else. Better braking from us there and a better exit. And now we're starting to create and make that little bit more space than we was making before. And yeah, like I said, it's a tough track, this one. You have to be high alert all the time, as we do love tap the wall with our left side rear, our left front wheel there. And yeah, Valtteri, I can feel the Finnish legend coming up my bottom. And yeah, he is really chomping on the bit now to try and get a bit on me. But as we have done this race, we have created that more space in the other final corners. Valtteri was really behind us, but as you do see, we are setting faster laps, which is not a good sign for us, because that means the car is in trouble. So we're gonna have a quick look over the car, see if there's anything going on. We do have tire wear, it says. We got major tire wear and anything else wrong with the car. Our ES system is not looking too good either, so the car is not going to be pumping out the power maybe it should be pumping out. But we are doing ever so well to make sure that we are keeping ourselves in this race. Obviously we could be doing a whole lot better, but we can only do what we can do, ladies and gentlemen, here in the race itself. Following it through now, coming down to the street section here, as we do brake and follow it around by the buildings, with Valtteri still just behind us, chomping at the bit to try and get our heels, but we are not letting him pass. We are doing a Gandalf and saying, "You shall not pass," as we majorly overturn that corner there. And that could have been a major problem there. We did slam on the brakes, but it just quite didn't work as well as we thought. And so now we need to make sure we keep an eye on our braking distance and all this, because we are going to be in major trouble here, as we're hard braking, really pushing right on that right thumbstick there. And yeah, honestly, it's not going well for me at the moment, as we do follow around to the left there into the old tight right hander, following it all the way through this snaky section. Mr. Singapore is really giving it to us here, and Valtteri is closing in as we do come around to this start line. This is where he creates his space, this is where he creates his opportunity. I have to make sure I'm blocking at all times, because Valtteri is going to keep trying it, as he goes for a major dive on that left side there. Mr. Valtteri Bottas, he is still pushing that left side. My goodness, Valtteri Bottas really wants to bring this race to me, and it's really putting me off right now, because I know that I can only hold on for so long before Valtteri gets his way. And yeah, that was a major move by Valtteri Bottas there, honestly. As you can see, the white little arrows coming up at the bottom, which is obviously to indicate they are close to me. When it does get to the third one, that is means he is basically right in my hose pipe. But ladies and gentlemen, this race so far, Valtteri, I can only hold him off for so long before the Finnishman is going to be able to fly past me. But we have to make sure that we are keeping what we can do to keep Valtteri behind us, because obviously I know, as we do a very bad turn there, which is allowing cars to push up against me. Who is that? That is Mr. Bottas I know that in the latest update they did change the power units, and I can definitely feel that with this Mercedes. It is challenging me more than any other car is on this track right now, and that is a worry for me. With the power unit upgrade, the Mercedes is absolutely giving it to me, making me feel the absolute pressure following it through. And yeah, my goodness, Valtteri Bottas, it's only a matter of time before the man takes over, but we have to just keep fighting as long as we can fight before. But we are going to go and go into the old pit lane right now. Hopefully Valtteri is going to follow us in. He does. Oh my goodness, I have cocked up. I thought that it did an automatic pit lane, but my god, we have rigged it up majorly there. I thought that the car was going to automatically take us into the pit, but my god, it has not. So now we're going to have to go out for another lap here and hope that we can get back into this race. That is a major mistake by me there, and we are in trouble, ladies and gentlemen. I thought that it was taking me automatically into the pit lane, but it just did not do what I thought it was going to do. So now I'm really going to have to make up some pace here. Another major mistake by me there, and my goodness, I thought my thoughts were wrong. I genuinely thought, oh yeah, it's going to take me into the pit automatically, and it did not. I still have my finger on the acceleration, and I slammed straight into the wall there. That is a major mistake, as we do see Charlie Leclerc ahead of us and Mr. Lando Norris behind us with Valtteri Bottas ahead of him. So that's good that Bottas is still out on the track, because that means that basically he is still going for it. And yeah, we got to make sure we go for the dive there on Leclerc, but our car is sodded up once more. This is not going well for me here, having to readjust the wheels, coming back onto the track quite dangerously there. That could be a time penalty, but my goodness, this is not going well for me right now. Nothing is going my way, as you can see all the flashing lights going off, taking pictures as we drive by, but this is not happening too good for me right now. We've made a major mistake as we do a love tap there on Ocon, giving him the basic nose, but he is squeezing me up against the wall. We do break through now, but the brake is just absolutely not helping. We are sliding all over the shop. The grip is just nowhere to be seen on these softs anymore. We are out on a lap that maybe we should have gone in on, and now we will be going in on the pit end entrance and making sure that we do follow the car around and making sure that, yeah, there we go. My goodness, this race has turned from bad to worse here, and we're going to really require a very quick pit stop from our team here. I can't say how quick it's going to be, but we're going to see right now as we are switching over to the mediums, and it looks like all the cars are leaving before us, and we do have Mr. Ocon behind us. We are now down in P12, and we have a lot of racing to do ahead of us, and a lot of overtaking we're going to need to do if we are going to take this P1, as we do slam into Perez there, trying to just get him on the outside. He's really squeezing me here with Lando Norris ahead of us. Now we're braking hard, but we're going to really have to slam down on the power to even stand the chances. We do have DRS, it is open. We're closing in on the McLaren of Lando Norris, but my goodness, you can really see the power upgrades in the cars on this particular patch update. All the other patch updates you couldn't see it, but my goodness, on this one you can, as we do come down now, squeezing Lando Norris outwards. We do have Alexandra Albon ahead of us. This is going to be insane now. We have to make sure we do what we can do, Alexandra Albon, and climb the board as fast as we can. We are still in the points, which is good for the team, but my goodness, this has not been our race. We have made mistake after mistake. We do love tap Albon there, taking his rear end as we overtake him there. Another warning for us. This is not good. We're going to get a penalty very shortly if we don't hurry up, as we do come through now with Charles Leclerc ahead of us, and then Carlos Sainz ahead of him. And yeah, this has not been a good race for your boy here. We have absolutely flubbed our lines. I genuinely cannot believe how bad we've actually raced this race. We screwed up the pit, and then we slammed into the wall, and we lost control of the car because of the tyre wear. But we have to do what we have to do for the team here, and we have to try and make sure we are keeping up with the pack, as Lewis Hamilton does set a fastest lap. And to be honest, it's going to be hard to catch up with him. And now we really have to put down the power. We got two of the fastest sectors there, So we have to make sure we get through this sector faster than we've ever done before, and if we want to get that fastest lap, obviously we don't deserve to be in the position we're in. Our car is a hell of a lot faster than any of these cars, but my goodness, what a absolute stinker I have had in this race. I genuinely cannot believe it. We have done so poorly. I thought going into this, obviously we're going to do bad, but not this bad. We have made two vital mistakes, and it has cost us very dearly. As you can see, the pack is ahead of us, so we are quite close to the pack. We've just got a lot of overtaking to do leading into the final few laps here, and we have to just get going. Charles Leclerc is just ahead of us, and then obviously ahead of him is Carlos Sainz, and we're going to have to brake, but we're going to have to make sure we keep on the power, because Charles Leclerc here is going to pull away, but that is a good little catch up from us there. Following it through onto the bridge section now, having to brake hard because this is the section where the corner is very tight. We do hit the front of, well, the back of Charles Leclerc now. DRS is open. We are opening the flaps, and we're going to go for a major dive down the left right side of Charles Leclerc. That was absolutely outrageous from us there. We really need to take Charlie Leclerc out there to even stand a chance. But now we have Carlos Sainz in our sights, and this is going to be a hell of a race if we can just climb up the leaderboard again. I will take a P3 or a P4 at this point, because I don't think we're going to get the P1. We've made way too many mistakes, but Carlos Sainz is just ahead of us there, and our car is a lot more powerful than what his is. So we're going to go for a late dive. Oh my goodness, we went for it, but Valtteri Bottas has set the fastest lap of the race. DRS is open. I have just set a fastest lap of the race with Charles Leclerc there. Carlos Sainz, we brake so heavy into that corner. It's unbelievable right now. Our racing is absolutely outrageous, almost taking Carlos Sainz straight off the track, but he managed to keep hold, and we do get the collision. Now we are climbing into nosebleed territory, with it being P5 just ahead of us of Danny Rick, but he is quite far ahead of us. The only way we're going to catch him is if we do some outrageous racing, and we need to make sure we are forever keeping on this power, because we're not going to catch him any other way, as we do see the front three ahead of us here of Verstappen, I think it's Verstappen, Ricciardo and Hamilton ahead of them. But my goodness, we have got a hell of a race on our hands here, as we do slam down the power here, following it around, make sure we are keeping as close as we can behind Danny Rick and everyone else of the pack. But now hard braking into the tight hander here, and following it all the way through. Now DRS is open for us, and we can slam down the power. Make sure we're going to go for a late break dive on Ricciardo there, but we slam into the wall and we absolutely cock ourselves. We have been reset back onto the track, thank the Lord. But that is Carlos Sainz and Leclerc regaining their positions. This has not been my race. I have done a major move there. And oh my goodness, I have lost it. I have lost my head here. I am absolutely bottling this race. I have a 3 second time penalty here to serve as well. But we are majorly behind everyone else now. There was a chance when we was behind Danny Ricciardo, but my goodness, we are in trouble. We are majorly in trouble here with Carlos Sainz just ahead of us here, and we are going to follow it around now with the DRS opening. We're going to have to make sure that we get a late break here on Carlos Sainz, really doing it bumper to bumper. Oh my goodness, really rubbing wheels there, tire on tire, as we do follow it way through now. And Danny Rick is just ahead of us, and we're having to restart what we just did, because we did get the 3 second time penalty. But my blimmin' God, this race has been absolutely craziness right now. And we're going to have to make sure that we drive quite clean for the rest of the race, because we will be in trouble. But this has been one of my worst races to date. Honestly, I have done so poorly in this race. I've made so many mistakes, and I also do have a 3 second time penalty. So I'll probably, no matter what my position is, I'm going to be bumped down to maybe one position below, but we are following it all the way through now. But somehow we still do have the fastest lap of the race coming over the bridge section here. Hard braking, because it is that tight left-hander, as we follow it around now. Danny Rick is ahead of us with Max Verstappen ahead of him. And then obviously you do have Valtteri and Hamilton ahead of them. I don't know who's ahead of Max there, so it's going to be interesting to see who that is. It does look like it is a Sebastian Vettel in the colourful red Ferrari car, but Jesus Christ, this has been an absolute stonker of a race. We're slowly catching up with the pack now, having to brake really hard, making sure that we make no mistakes here. And yeah, the pack behind us are just behind us, but we have it. We're almost there on Danny Rick. We're going to be within touching distance of the Australian when we come around to this start point here, as we can full power all the way through now, really slamming down on the power for to catch the old Danny Rick there, as he is just ahead of us, having to brake a little bit, but following the full power all the way through now, slamming on the brakes just a little bit, but make sure we slam down the power as soon as we get the exit. But my blimmin' goodness, this is crazy, crazy, crazy stuff right now. And yeah, we are doing absolutely fantastically following all the problems we have had. I would take a P6. Obviously, I'd prefer to be high, but I don't know if it's going to be possible for us to catch the pack now. Obviously, we had the chance to when we was right up Danny Rick's shoulder, but this has been a major problem here. We were right up his shoulder, and then we had another major spin out or another major wall sort of collision thing. And yeah, this could be our, this could be the nail in the coffin for us as we do follow it around now, keeping on the power and cutting that corner just slightly, coming over the bridge section now. Danny Rick is ahead of us, braking hard. We can still do this, ladies and gents. We can still catch up with Danny Ricciardo, following him through now on the straight. He is going to be braking right about now. We are braking as well. We are following him up and around through the corner, working these sections after sections, following it through on the Renault. It is feeling us breathing down his neck right now. We genuinely cannot be any closer to him than we already are. And yeah, we are seeing all the other cars ahead of us, and we're going to have to make sure we drive very carefully here to try and catch up with the Danny Ricciardo, as he does pull away just a little bit there, but he's going to have to brake a little bit as we follow him round now into the straight. And this is where we can try and make up some space, as DRS is open for us, and we're now going to be breathing down Danny Ricciardo's neck. But he has braked, and we are still following him through, braking even more for us. But we are obviously right up his backside, still can smell the Renault's engine burning away as we do almost try. I was thinking about going for the right-hander dive, but we didn't. Yellow flag is ahead. There is something that's gone on here. Max Verstappen is out there. His engine is absolutely combusted, and this is not good for Max. He was doing so well. But Danny Rick, we have to concentrate on the race ahead, as we do go for a right-handed dive there on Danny Ricciardo, and we do pull it off there. And now we have the little task of getting after Vettel now to get back onto the podium. But my goodness, this race has been nothing short of absolute drama and thrills and spills. We can catch Sebastian Vettel here as long as we do amazing driving coming over this bridge section. But that Ferrari is absolutely bonza and very quick as we do follow it now. But the car is not going to have to be able to withstand the power of my car. Both the silver arrows are ahead of us, which is not good, as Hamilton is our rival, and obviously he is probably going to get the podium. But we have to make sure that we concentrate on what we are doing right now, and that is trying to take out Sebastian Vettel to try and get back onto that podium, which is where we started and which is where we do belong as we do come around now. Really, really great racing here, trying to absolutely do everything we can to get back into this race. Exceeded track limits, warning, this is not good for us. We still have the 3 second time penalty as we do follow it around now. Sebastian Vettel is going to be feeling the pressure, and here we go, slamming down the DRS on Sebastian Vettel. We're going to be overtaking him any time shortly. He knows this, and as we do slam down the power here, trying to make sure we get Sebastian Vettel here. And he is feeling the pressure of my car now as we do slam down the power. The Ferrari did take a big hit on the engine side of things as we do come round. Really, really giving it some. And we do have DRS is open now. Sebastian Vettel is in trouble. We are closing in on the German himself to see if we can now go for a late break on that left side. But we don't. It is way too dangerous to try that maneuver in that tight corner as we do brake now. But it is not going to be long before we do overtake Sebastian Vettel now, coming down to this left side here. Really hard braking there, slamming into Vettel, but we do get the overtake, and we are now in P3, and we have made lots and lots of positions here. And I'm sorry, but if I don't get driver of the day at this point, I honestly don't know what else I have to do to get driver of the day, because I have taken up so many positions from where I was, and I'm still going for the positions, and we do almost lose it there with Sebastian Vettel giving it some on the side there, but we are now pulling away from Seb Vettel, and we have to look for those Mercedes there just ahead of us, both of them tussling for that first position, but we are now tussling with Mr. Sebastian Vettel for his position too. But we have got the fastest lap of the race, which is absolutely outrageous considering where we was, having to brake quite a lot now coming into the under the bridge section. And we have done so well in this race to be able to overtake all the cars that we have and to be back into P3 considering how far down the leaderboard we was. But I did say before this race that the Mercedes car is absolutely outrageous, and it is proving it right now. They are so far ahead, it is absolutely unbelievable. And we're going to have to really do some great racing here to even catch any of them as we do break now. Coming through to this left-hander here, making sure we are doing what we can do whilst racing, and following it all the way around now. And you can see just in the distance there the Mercedes. I don't think it's going to be possible for me to catch them, but if you said to me I was in P16 and I went all the way up to P3 near the end of the race, I would absolutely take that. I would gobble up that opportunity, ladies and gentlemen. But yes, we have done so well in this race. Well, I say so well, but very poorly from us, because we had such a bad pit and we had so many crashes and so many bad things has happened to us. But I did say before this race that this track is not one of my favourites, and as you have seen, there has been major complications for me with this track. And we just have to keep doing what we've got to do, and that is trying to just do the best racing we possibly can. And continuing to close the gap on the Mercedes, but like I said, I don't think it is going to be possible for us to overtake any of them, because as soon as they get on these straights, they are away like a very big elastic band. They are absolutely pinging away from us, and I do think that we're probably going to be knocked down to P4 because of our 3 second time penalty, but All in all, we've done very well, and if we didn't get the time penalty, obviously we'd be finishing in the position we are, but because we did get the time penalty, because I did do a very bad racing line, then obviously we're going to be finishing in the P4, but we are pulling away now from Seb Vettel himself, and trying to catch up with these Mercedes, but like I said, on this final lap, it's going to be very difficult to catch up with any of them, considering how quick their cars are. I literally am seeing them always in the distance, not anywhere near enough to be able to, you know, catch them or do anything about it, as they do pull away so strongly on these straights, as we do follow it all the way around now. And maybe there is an opportunity here for me to overtake, but it's very, very rare for us to do it. But if we just had one more lap, then maybe something could have happened, but we don't have that one more lap that we are asking for. We just have this lap and this lap only to be able to try and do something with these Mercedes. As you can see, my fuel engine light is flickering away there, telling me that this is all the car's got with the petrol wise, and that we are having to really give it all as we do tap the right side there, following it through, hard braking now and giving it a tap as we do pull away from that corner there, and pulling away from anything and everyone, as we did get very close there to the Mercedes, following it all the way through, and now slamming down the power, hitting the left side there. But we are, honestly, if we had one more lap here, we would have had the Mercedes, we would have had them both, but we don't have the one more lap. We only have this lap and this lap only, following it around now on the tight right hander, following it through behind Valtteri Bottas and Lewis Hamilton, speeding through now, having to brake even more, and they are pulling away as we do try and slam down the speed now for this final corner. We're going to give it absolutely everything, and the checkered flag has been erased, and my goodness, if we had one more lap, that would have been it. But we have got the P3 in what was an absolute vanity race. I genuinely cannot believe it. Lewis Hamilton got fucking driver of the day. I don't know how. I literally climbed 100 fucking spots. But Toto Wolff there, we're not going to even watch a silly podium, even though I'm on it. But I cannot bear to see the Mercedes on the podium. That is so irritating. We just, honestly, we did so well. And if we just had one more lap, we would have absolutely had it in our hands. I could honestly taste it in my hands, as you can see there. Lewis Hamilton takes pole, Valtteri Bottas second, and us third. But my goodness, what an episode. What a, you know, honestly, what an absolutely everything. And yeah, I genuinely cannot believe that just happened. Let's see what happened with let's see what happened with Mr. Jack Aitken here, and yeah, let's see where he finished. He finished in P20 when he started in P19, so he did lose a spot to Russell. But my goodness, we did get the fastest lap, and we did keep our P3, which is very nice to see. But yes, guys, this has been the episode of F1 2020. I hope you guys and girls have enjoyed it. If you're brand new around here, please do hit the sub button. If you're new around here, please hit the like button. I've been Jake, and I'll see you dudes and dudettes in my next video. Peace, guys. Woo!